السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين، لا سيما بقية الله في الأرضين، أجل الله تعالى فرجه الشريف وجعلنا من أعوانه وأنصاره. Last night we talked about the concept of nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and with the help of some hadith we try to define what would be the actual turning point from where you are counted as muqarrab. We said that as soon as you embark on a journey towards perfection, towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are mutaqarrib. But mutaqarrib is different from muqarrab. Mutaqarrib is seeking nearness, but it's not yet near. Muqarrab is the one who is brought near. Like, for example, if I moving towards Mashhad. So maybe, for example, I have to go 1,000 kilometers. So from the moment I leave my house, I am mutaqarrib. I'm getting closer and closer. Still maybe 999 kilometers is ahead, but I am mutaqarrib because I have gone a little bit further. But I cannot say I am near Mashhad. Still lots of distance is ahead of me. It's only at a certain distance that when you reach, then we can say now you are close. Not seeking closeness. Now you are close or near. So I said that is the time that when we perform our wajibat and then mustahabbat and establish obedience to Allah in ourselves. So it's not a matter of more actions, it's a matter of turning these actions into a quality of obedience. This is very important. Sometimes you have acts of obedience and sometimes you have the quality of obedience. These are two different things. Sometimes you have generous acts, sometimes you have generosity. These are two different things. So if you turn your acts of obedience into obedience, your acts of worship and service to Allah into serving Allah and becoming His servant, then you are near Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls this new situation, which is very much different from before, Allah calls this life. You are given a new life. Before that, you are in this sense dead. You have physical life, but you don't have this life, which is for the people who are close to Allah, who is Al-Hayy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَجِيبُوا لِلَّهِ وَلِلْرَّسُولِ إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ. O those who have faith, respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger when He invites you. إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ, not إِذَا دَعَوَاكُمْ. When He means the Prophet, on behalf of Allah, as representative of Allah, invites you to what gives you life. Da'akum means he is inviting you, lema towards yuhyikum, gives you life. So the Prophet has come not only to change our life, he has come also to give us a new life. This is more than just changing our life. When you become mu'min, your life changes. Your lifestyle should change. But if you keep practicing and getting closer and closer, then not only your life is changed, but also you will be given a second life. Elsewhere, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the same thing in a different way. مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً. Those who do righteous deeds while they are faithful, whether they are men or women, it doesn't make difference. Zakar or Unsa, perfection is available for men and women. If you have iman and do righteous deeds, Allah says we would certainly, فَلَنُحْيَيَنَّ, with emphasis, He says certainly we will revive you. We will give you a new life, which we call Hayata Tayyibah. We will give you a pleasant life. Allama Tabatabai Rahmatullah Alayhi in Al-Mizan, when he comments on this ayah, very clearly, he says, this is not change of your existing life. This is a new life. Don't think that this is the same life, but with a different quality. This is totally a new life. And those who don't have this life, they are dead with respect to this life. They are dead. Elsewhere, Allah says, أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ كَمَنْ مَثَلُهُ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ لَيْسَ بِخَارِجٍ مِنْهَا. Is the one who is dead, and then we gave him life. أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا. So it means that without this, you are dead. Then we gave him life, and we gave him light. Life of this stage comes with light. And this light is not light which comes in the, you know, hereafter on the Day of Judgment. This is the light that you will be given in dunya. Because it says, جَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ. He is given a light by which he walks among the people. Or elsewhere Allah says, نُورًا تَمْشُونَ بِهِ فِي الْأَسْوَاقِ. Allah gives you a life by which you go to university, you go to your office, you go to your factory, you go to your kitchen. This is light in dunya. So, is the one who was dead, and then we gave him life and light by which he walks among people, similar to the one who is in darknesses. فَالظُّلُمَاتِ, not فَالظُّلْمَ, فَالظُّلُمَاتِ. Zulumat is plural. When we are away from God, we don't have only one problem. We would have thousands of problems. We think that we have only one problem, we lack iman. No. Then you would have problem in every corner of your life. كَمَنْ مَسَلُهُ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ لَيْسَ بِخَارِجٍ مِنْهَا. He is not coming out of the zulumat. To be in darkness, in a sense, is natural for us. What is important is whether are you coming out or not. لَيْسَ بِخَارِجٍ مِنْهَا means لَيْسَ يَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا. He is not coming out. Are these two people the same? So, by responding to the call of the Prophet, by accepting the invitation of the Prophet, by obeying the Prophet, then we can achieve a new life, which is called Hayata Tayyiba. Why this is called Hayata Tayyiba? And what is the relation between this and happiness? Tayyiba means pure and pleasant. Tayyib means something which is pure, clean, and at the same time, pleasant. Taba means something that you like, you don't have any problem. Ma taba lakum means whatever you like. At-tayyibat lit-tayyibin. Opposite to khabithat, khabithin. So tayyib is something which is clean, which is pure, which is nice, which is pleasant. So you are either given a new life, which makes your whole experience of this world enjoyable, or you are dead with respect to this life and you are only enjoying your physical life in this dunya, which is full of problems. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدٍ. If this is the life of dunya, if it is only worldly life, it would be full of pain, difficulties. If that life comes, then it's so enjoyable that even the pains of the physical life would be undershadowed. This is mentioned also in Surah Taha. In Surah Taha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that when Adam alayhi salam, Allah nabiyyina wa alayhi salam, was warned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about the danger of Iblis, Allah told him, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فقلنا يا آدم إن هذا عدو لك ولزوجك. O Adam, this is an enemy of you and your wife. Allah didn't say you have an enemy, be careful. No, even Allah pointed, Hadha. How Allah pointed to Iblis, it's not for sure by finger, but somehow Allah made it clear that I am referring to a specific person. Okay? Anna hadha. Not that you have an enemy. Anna hadha. And the ayah before is about Iblis when refused to do sajda. So Allah very clearly said that this person is your enemy, an enemy of your wife. فَلَا يُخْرِجَنَّكُمَا مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ. Be careful. He has made the decision to send you outside this garden. Be careful not let him send you outside. What is going to happen if you go outside? فَتَشْقَى. As soon as you go outside, it doesn't say ثُمَّ تَشْقَى, it says فَتَشْقَى. Means as soon as you come out, you will start suffering. Here in this garden, you have immunity, you have comfort, everything is guaranteed for you. But outside, there is a problem. إِنَّ لَكَ أَلَّا تَجُوعَ فِيهَا وَلَا تَعْرَى. Here, you don't become hungry. You don't need to worry about dress because you will never become wicked. لا تعرى. وَأَنَّكَ لَا تَظْمَأُ فِيهَا وَلَا تَظْهَى. You don't need air conditioning. So here everything is okay, but you go out, you have to worry about food, about dress, about shelter, about temperature. All these difficulties come. فَوَسْوَسَ إِلَيْهِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Then Iblis went to Adam alayhi salam and started bringing all the temptations. I don't mention what was the temptation. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعَصَى آدَمُ رَبَّهُ فغبا. He disobeyed. He didn't take the advice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he was misguided. ثُمَّ اجْتَبَاهُ رَبُّهُ. But Allah was very kind, forgiving. So Allah chose him again. فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ وَحَدَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his tawbah, returned towards him, guided him. Then, after some words, Allah says, فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدًى. When a guide from me comes to you. So now you are on the earth. So you have already shaqa. Suffering is there, okay? Suffering for food, for dress, for shelter, temperature, all the problems of dunya is there. But when a guide from me comes to you, فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَايِ, if you follow the guidance which has come from me, فَلَا يَظِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى, then he would not go astray and he would not suffer. What does it mean he would not suffer? Does it mean that then again he doesn't need to worry about food? No, he still has to worry about food. Does it mean he doesn't need to worry about dress? No, he has to worry about this. But when you follow that guidance, you will be given a life on top of the worldly life that would make all the problems of dunya insignificant, and you would enjoy that hayat al-tayyibah, which is pleasant. So your suffering is not important. The physical suffering would no longer be a trouble. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي. But if instead of following the guidance, you turn away from me, you don't follow the guidance so that you remember me, you decide to do your own things, you turn away from my remembrance, فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ, then you would have a very difficult, narrow life. Ma'ishatan. Even Allah doesn't say hayatan, he says ma'ishatan. You have very low level of life with troubles, suffering. وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةَ أَعْمَى. And on the day of judgment, then we would resurrect this person as a blind person. قَالَ رَبِّ لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا. Oh Allah, when I was in dunya, I was able to see. Perhaps there is a mistake here. They thought I was blind. No, I was not blind. I was able to see. Why you have resurrected me blind? I am supposed to be resurrected in the way I used to be. Allah says, no, sorry, this is not the rule. If you were able to see with hayat tayyibah, it means that if the eyes of your heart were able to see, you will have again the vision. But if you were able to see just by the physical eyes, now you cannot see. You are dead. You are blind. You are deaf. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَّسِيْتَهَا. No. This is exactly your situation. In dunya, my verses, my signs, my communications came to you. You didn't pay attention. So even in dunya, you were blind. وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. You forget my signs, my communications, now you are forgotten. So nothing has changed. It's the same thing which is now manifest. So, according to Quran, according to Islam, we can choose between two situations. One is to be pleased with this life that we have and do our best to have delicious food, you know, nice drink, nice dress, good house. But then we have to know that, first of all, this doesn't guarantee our happiness in the hereafter. And second, this even doesn't guarantee our happiness in this world. Because these cannot be achieved easily. These cannot be also achieved free from pain and trouble of first gaining them and second protecting them. All the time you have to worry how to earn, how to protect, how to keep your health, how to push away death. Can you push away death? No. So it's all the time troublesome. The other option is you respond to the invitation of the Prophet, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You obey the Prophet, you do righteous deeds, and then you would be given a new life. A life which would endure death, so your akhirah is guaranteed, but also would change your experience of even dunya, a different one. You don't suffer anymore when you have worldly problems. Maybe you have fever, maybe you have a headache, but you don't suffer in your heart. These are on the surface. Life for you is meaningful. The problems, no matter how much they are, never make you commit suicide or say, oh Allah, please take away my life. Why? Because you are so much enjoying that life, the second life that you have, that these are not important. Like, you know, when you go to Hajj, you have lots of difficulties. Yeah? But still, you are happy that you are there. You don't want to go back. And next year again, when the season of Hajj comes, although you know that there will be lots of problems, still you want to go. Because you know that you would have something for which all these problems are not important, not significant. Or like, for example, a person who says, I want to go and study. Okay, life of a student is not easy. But when you love to learn, when you love knowledge, when you want to become a scholar, a scientist, then all those difficulties would not stop you. Indeed, those difficulties sometimes become enjoyable, especially when you go through them and come out. The most difficult time you had in university or in the seminary becomes the best memories of you. You say to your children or friends, there was a time we didn't have anything to eat. And you wish that there were more of these times, because it becomes like an achievement. So you are not regretting, or you are not sorry for those problems. So this is a life which is available to us. مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٍ فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And then on the day of judgment, Allah says, we would certainly reward them in a very special way. How does Allah reward such people? Allah says, we will reward them according to the best of what they were doing. What does it mean? If this person in his life, he prayed 100,000 rak'ah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses the best salat that he performed and says, I take this as the measure and I will reward all your salat according to this measure. Ahsan ma kanu ya'mal. In all your life, 1 month of Ramadan was the best month of Ramadan. I will reward you for all those months of Ramadan of your life according to the best one. In all your ziyarat, one was the best. I will reward you according to the best. لَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Allama Tabatabai says something which is even more than this, but I don't say that. I say just to this much. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would reward such people according to the most spiritual, most pious experience that they had. The best experience that they had. This is the kindness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, it's like, for example, if a teacher throughout the year gives 10, 20 papers, weekly, monthly, for terms, then instead of either giving the last mark for the final exam or, you know, putting them together and give the average, he says, if in one of these exams you had the best mark, I will give this to you and put it in your file that you have got this for all the exams. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala treats these people. لَنَجْزِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. This is Hayat al-Tayyibah, in which there is also no fear, no grief, as we said, إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. So, we are to choose. No one can choose for you. No matter, you know, our father, mother, friends, how much they love us, how much they care, how much they are concerned, they cannot choose for us. Every person has to choose for himself and herself, whether we want this or not. They cannot do anything to put us on this way, in this way. We have to choose and be committed to this path. Then you can go even higher. This is my understanding. So far, you are a person who has iman, amal salih, has achieved hayat tayyibah. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says there are people who are to be taken as role models. They are to be taken as signs for other people not to be misguided. You know, sometimes you are on the right path, but you are struggling. But there are people, not only they are on the right path, they are signs for other people so that they know how they can be on the right path. We say, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. What does it mean? Please guide us and keep us on the right path. اِهْدِنَا here means guide us and keep us on the right path. But صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِ. But this, the path that I am struggling to find and to remain on it, is the path of people that you have bestowed your blessings on them. An'amta alayhim. This is sirat al-ladin. This is their sirat. I am temporarily here. Do you get my point? Sirat al-ladin an'amta alayhim means this is their path. I am just learning. I am just following them. Elsewhere, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Man yuti'i Allah wa rasul. If you have ta'a, if you have obedience, as we explained, فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. So, أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ, أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ, they are really the owners of this path. We want to be with them. We want to follow them. Who are those people? مَنْ يُتَعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ. First group, prophets. Prophets are the signs, are the hujjat of Allah. When you find them, you are sure that you are on the right path. You don't need to worry. If you look at me, you have to still be worried. Why? Because even if I'm on the right path, anytime I can go away, I can deviate. Okay? So I am not hujja for you. But if you find one of those four groups of people, which of course they overlap, Nabiyin, the prophets, Vashuhada, the witnesses, Vassaddiqeen, those who are truthful, most truthful, Vassalihin, those who are righteous. Salih is different from the one who does amal salih. There are people who amalu salihat, man amila salihan. But then there are people who have become themselves salih. It's different. So if you are one of these four groups of people, mashallah. If you are not one of these four groups of people, at least try to be with these people. وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ الرَّفِيقَ. What a good companions they are. Imagine, you know, if you are going to a trip and the Prophet is in your caravan, in your group, or a witness, a shaheed, or a person who is salih, or a person who is siddiq, so you don't have any problem. So these are the people who are on the right path, and this path belongs to them. It's impossible to find them away from this path, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us to join them. How can we join them? By yuti'illaha wa rasul. So if we decide to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, commit ourselves to this ta'ah, follow the company of these people, gradually we reach a point that then you yourself also become one of them. You become so close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that then you yourself become salih. You yourself become siddiq. There is no reason why we cannot be one of them. We cannot be a prophet for sure. But we cannot be siddiq. We can be siddiq. We can be salih. It's by consistency, it's by following the path that we can reach that point. Then people can look at you and be inspired. People can look at you and learn. People can look at you and forget their problems. You know, sometimes there are people that they are so connected to Allah, so spiritual, that when you are with them, you don't feel any problem. You don't feel any pain. Once some of the companions of the Prophet told the Prophet, when we are with you, we are very spiritual. We feel very good, as if we are in a sky. But when we go out, then the situation changes. The Prophet said, if you were able to remain in the same condition, then you were able to shake hands with the angels. So when they are with the Prophet, they feel differently. And alhamdulillah, we have also people, not in that caliber, but we have among our ulama, among our pious scholars, people that when you are with them, you feel very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you are with them, then you don't worry that my car is not good, my house is small, or I have a rented house. When you come out, you go on the street, meet with the people, then all these problems come to your mind. So it's to us to choose what type of direction, what type of lifestyle to choose, which would end either with being with such people and then gradually becoming one of them, inshallah, or being in the state of death, being resurrected blind, suffering in dunya and suffering more in akhirah. So one of the two. Inna hadaynahu sabil, imma shakiran wa imma kafura. I hope that inshallah, and I pray that inshallah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to live such a life that we will never regret. There was a very pious teacher in Tehran. He had no child. He dedicated his life to teaching children. He was a very pious person. towards the end of his life, you know, he had illness. He was very ill, and then he died. Some people visited him when he was very ill and told him, now that you are in end of your life with lots of experiences, if Allah gives you a new life, what will you do? This is very important. If Allah gives me a new life, what will I do? He said, I will do the same thing that I did. This is very important. Are we able to say the same thing? Honestly, maybe, you know, just we pretend, but honestly, this man was a very honest person and he was dying, so he had no interest, you know, in deceiving people and was a pious person. He says, I lived such a life that I don't regret. All my life, I try to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, serve people, educate people. I don't regret. Am I able to say the same thing? Am I able to say that even 50% of my life I am happy with? Or sometimes we feel that we have wasted all our life. If Allah gives me a new life, I will totally change. But of course, this is something that we say, and if we are even given 100 times life, we will do the same thing. إِنَّهَا كَلِمَةٌ هُوَ قَائِلُهَا. Let us remember again the tragedy of Karbala and Our Lady, and inshallah ask Allah for help. This is about the very last part of the life of the lady. As-salamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah wa ala al-arwah allati halat bifnaik عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبغي الليل والنهار ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين وعلى زينب أخت الحسين جان و دلم فدای تو ای دلبرم حسین دیگر رسید از دم آخرم حسین My brother حسین may I be your ransom This is the last moment of my life. من رو به کربلای تو خوابیدم اخا دیدار من بیا پسر مادرم I am sleeping towards Karbala. Please come to see me, son of my mother Hussein.
چیزی نماند از تو به جز کن پیران، این یادگار توست کنون در برم Nothing from you is left for me except the old shirt which is with me. یک سال و نیم رفته ز عمر و نمی شود، درد نبودنت به خدا باورم زد. It is 1.5 years after your martyrdom, but Zainab still cannot believe that you have left her alone. یک سال و نیم مثل رباب تو می زدم بر صورتم ز داغ علی از غرام حسین. Like the mother of Ali Asghar, in this 1.5 year I was crying and lamenting for my Ali Asghar. پیچیده است وقت اذان توی گوش من، الله اکبر علی اکبر حسین. Still the voice of my Ali Akbar when he was reciting اذان is in ears of Zainab. یادم نمی رود که صدای تو قطع شد، افتاد دل هره به میان حرم حسین. I cannot forget the time that your voice stopped. The people in the Haram were not able to hear your voice, so they all realized the tragedy. بالای تل دویدم و دیدم که میخوری، شمشیر و نیزه پیش دو چشم ترم حسین. Then I rushed and went on the top of the hill and I saw that swords and spears are coming to you in front of my eyes. چهره کبود بود شب غارت حرم، چهره کبود بود شب غارت حرم، هر دختری که بود به دور و برم حسین. In the night when they attacked the tents, when I was looking at the face of your daughters, they were all bruised. در کربلا زدند به پیشانی تو سنگ، در شام سنگ خورد همه پیکرم حسین. In Karbala the enemy threw a stone which hit your forehead. But in Sham, your enemies hit with their stones all my body. هرچه گذشت بین محل یهودیان، با خود به زیر خاک سیاه میبرم حسین. Oh Hussein, but I am not telling you what they did to me. in that part of Sham which was inhabited by those non-Muslims. Ala la'natullah ala al-qawm al-zalimin. وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منغلب ينغلبون.
This is the last night of our majlis. This is the time that we have to make sure that inshallah we have achieved something.
نسألك اللهم وندعوك باسمك العظيم الأعظم العز الأجل الأكرام وبالقرآن المستحكم وبفاطمة وأبيها وبعلها وبنيها والسر المستودع فيها يا الله 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 يا رحمن يا رحيم يا أرحم الراحمين يا مغلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك ثبت قلوبنا على دينك واكفنا يا قاضي الحاجات ويا كافي المهمات إنك على كل شيء قدير.
I just end with a dua of faraj.
اللهم كل وليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا وامنن علينا برضاه وهب لنا رأفته ورحمته ودعاه وخيره برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.